Nupur, you were talking about you were talking about faith in the system. You're from the industry itself. You've done movies. Indrajit says that given that public faith in the political system is at an all-time low, maybe this entire case should go out from Karnataka and be part of a CBI investigation. What do you think? Do you think that the film industry is being made into a scapegoat? I am not casting aspersions on the investigation. That is continuing. But given what everybody is saying, do you think it would be better if a central agency investigated this?
Shiv, I was told that this is going to be a topic about the film industry and drugs. And to give due respect to both the politicians on the panel, they have made it into a very political debate rather than just films and drugs. However, to answer your question, I think the case should definitely go to the CBI. It should be investigated by the ED also, and it should be investigated by the Narcotics Control Bureau, by the NCB as well. Mm. And I have full faith in my investigating authorities of my country. They are very, very, they have very good potential, and they are very good at their work. And I'm sure they're going to come up with great, investigations. So great results. So I think the case should definitely, as Indrajit said, that the case should go to CBI. So yes, I am in complete agreement with him.
Okay.
I think the case should go to CBI because it's a very, very high regarded case, because this drug mafia is now expanding and exploding and it's just magnifying like rabbits, so I think and because of certain group of people who do drugs in the industry, the entire industry is being blamed.
Okay,
if one
okay.
egg is rotten, people are saying the entire basket of egg is rotten.
Indrajit,
so that
yeah.
should not happen.
Okay, Indrajit,
so entire industry
bringing you back in
rotten.
Okay, Indrajit, go for it. You were telling you wanted to raise another point, and we'll get the politicians to answer that as well.
See, the reason why I asked for a CBI is, of course, the BJP spokesman is saying that Jameer is the accused. If there's any evidence, fine, you go in for an investigation. I agree with that, if there is evidence. And also, there are the Congress spokesman is also saying that the Ragini was in the BJP, and there's a lot of BJP politicians supporting her. In fact, when she was arrested on the first day, there was a BJP politician calling up and asking her to be released. So there is a lot of reports on this. So when there is political pressures, of course, we have an able joint commissioner who we have seen his track record in Mangalore. The Mangalore was a capital hub for drug mafia in Karnataka. It is now shifted to Bangalore.
Okay.
So it's now Bangalore is the drug mafia, and even Mr. Sandeep Patil will have political pressures. From the Congress, wherein Jameer is being accused of casinos and drug mafia, a lot of accusations.
Let's get S. Prakash to answer that. S. Prakash, Indrajit is saying that, it's one thing to make all the noises.
The BJP, a lot of leaders were seen with the person who's accused, Ragini. So they were saying that she was about to join BJP. And the day she was arrested, there were BJP people putting pressure on the police. So of all these reasons, I feel the CBI should enter and clean up the whole system.
Respond to that, S. Prakash. Indrajit says that the investigation cannot be fair for the reasons that he has enunciated. Respond to that. Those are pretty grave charges against the BJP.
No, he's free to express his opinion. He believes CBI is the most competent authority to probe this. The CCB is doing a wonderful job. Just because a few leaders were seen with Ragini in a photograph about a year back or very recently, you cannot cast aspersions on that. She is seen with Siddaramaiah, she is seen with B.K. Shivakumar, seen with many other politicians. See, let us not rivalize to all such things. The case is going the right direction.
But again, we've made it only about Ragini.
Politicizing the issue will only allow the drug peddlers and the accused to get away.
I'll come to Indrajit. One second.
Allow the police to function. If the police...
But why are we only talking about Ragini? There will be thousands of Ragini in the industry.
Correct. Or in politics.
It is moving... I know. Why? What is the obsession with so many that why politicians are not in it? If the politicians not don't have any evidence to arrest, you want them to be put behind the bar without any evidence just because you want to take a satisfaction that the politicians are involved? Sir, very sorry, sir.
No, but Nupur asks a correct question.
In the same
I just want to say face. Nupur asks a correct question. She says Ragini has become the face. There may be 100 other Raginis there. There may be Raginis of the politics also. Where are the Raginis of the politics?
Let's catch hold of all the Raginis.
Let everybody be exposed.
In the industry.
Why only Ragini? Even others also should be arrested. Not why only 10 peddlers. Karnataka has many more peddlers. Everyone should be brought to books.
But of course, and how will that happen, sir? Who will do that? Who will get the peddlers?
That's the job of the police. And that is the job of the police, who are doing a wonderful job. Give them some space. Why are you in a hurry to get everybody arrested overnight? Which was there? This industry, this drug mafia is not yesterday's. It is there from decades. At least now some focus is there on to eradicate it.